What's up, guys? Graham here.
I think it's about time for a giveaway. This giveaway is 5 of the Merry Mink Trove lockboxes, so yes, we will have 5 winners. If you're one of the people that used my referral link whenever you created your Rift account, then if you're one of the winners, then you win 5 times the amount of the reward. Yes, that means that even though we have 5 winners, you will win 5 of the Troves yourself. To enter into this giveaway is very simple. All you have to do is leave a comment in the comment section below with your character and server, and also make sure you are subscribed to the channel because that is definitely required. And make sure that you hit that like button because it always helps. Winner will be announced in the next Saturday video. Good luck, everybody. What's up, guys? Graham here. Today we're going to go into a Paragon variation that was provided to me by Jegadin at Seastone. And I've been playing with this build and I've really been liking it. And I will be sending you a couple of wrecks, buddy. I appreciate the build and I hope every one of you are going to enjoy it as well. This is a Paragon version that is going to be able to take a little bit more damage than the other Paragon builds that you're used to seeing, probably. Because the problem with Warrior right now is that almost every build went into Warlord in the past because Warlord provided very good damage and also survivability. Well, now the survivability has been scaled down, so now people are trying to go into a lot of other builds. They're trying to mix in Void Knight with Paragon and Paladin with Paragon and all kinds of different stuff, and really it's not really working out too well by what I've seen, and I really like this build, so I'm going to share it with you. Alright, so let's go into the soul tree here. And if you would like to see this build on a web page instead of trying to squint at your screen here, I will have a link in the description below, so go ahead and check it out down there and it'll navigate you to the Magello page where you can see the actual build on a web page. Alright, so as you can see, we went into Paragon, Tempest, and Beastmaster. And I'll explain the Beastmaster part in just a moment. But naturally, you fill up the whole Paragon tree there. And the 9 points we went into Tempest, we went 5 into Amped, 3 into Difficult Target, and 1 into Elude. Now, if you don't have the Tempest Soul, I recommend you go into Champion for the extra charge. And it also has quite a bit of damage increase points to put in. So our 6 points that we went into Beastmaster is 5 into Swiftness and 1 into Call of Stone. Now the reason why we went with Beastmaster is because with Swiftness it increases your movement speed by 10% and increases your damage by 5%. Now that may not seem like that much to you, but actually the 10% movement increase is going to help you survive. Because with Warrior damage, it's pretty much get in, kill some people, or stay as long until you take too much damage, and then being able to get out. And if you're not able to get out fast enough, they're going to kill you. And, well, Swiftness provides a little bit more of a movement increase that will help you out quite a bit, I think. And also with Call of Stone, that reduces the damage that you take by 5%, and it affects everybody in the entire raid. So if you're in Conquest or a Warfront, everybody is going to benefit from this Call of Stone, and they're all going to take 5% less damage. Alright, the masteries that we're going into is the 61 is Enduring Survival, 62 is Physiology Proficiency, 63 is Runner's Training, 64 is Deliberate Strikes, 65 is Power Manipulation, and I went into this for a bit more burst. And the reason for that being is because I'm noticing with the Beastmaster abilities, I'm taking less damage, I can get out easier, and with Elude from Tempest, I mean, everything is just really helping out to where I'm not dying all that much anymore. And if you are having trouble surviving, if you're just not getting used to getting in, getting out fast enough, one of the things that you might want to go into is power variation. And power variation is a big time heal, but it's a channeled heal, so it can be interrupted. But if you can pull it off, it's going to heal you for a lot of health. And the reason why I kind of pointed out Elude is it's not only a leap back, but it also removes all crowd control effects. So if somebody has locked you down, even if you're facing in the wrong direction that you don't want to leap back in the direction you're facing, then, you know, just use it as a crowd control break, just like your break free. All right, so let's go ahead and go into the buffs here. Our buffs are Turn the Blade, Empower, Focus the Body, Way of the Mountain, Way of the Wind, Enhanced Conductivity, and Call of Stone, and then any planar or guild buffs that you want to use. Alright, so let's go ahead and go into the macros here. Now, all of the macros will be in the description below this video, so you can go down there and copy and paste them. If you're unable to copy, you most likely have a bad browser, and you probably need to switch to a better browser. That way you can copy and paste from YouTube as well. Alright, so the builder here is going to do a lot of damage, but it is a builder. It's not meant to cast your most powerful abilities just yet. And as you can see right at the end, we got Shock Pulse, so if you don't have the Tempest Soul, you're not going to have Shock Pulse, so your ranged attack is going to be missing there. I went ahead and threw in all the planar abilities as well at the end of my macro. If you guys do not have all of those, then take them out as needed. I'm not going to put them in the macro that I have listed below, but if you want them, you can see how I got them right there. Alright, so our finisher macro is going to be Reaping Harvest and Skyfall, which Reaping Harvest is going to be pretty much our hardest hitting ability that we have, and you want to use it as much as possible, and it's going to be in our burst macros as well. Well, we also have Skyfall there, which is a ranged finisher and really going to help out whenever people start kiting you around. If you don't have the Tempest Soul, you will not have Skyfall, so take it out of your macro. Alright, our first burst macro here is basically Shifting Blades and then a lot of extremely hard hitting abilities after that. So you can alter this any way you want. Some people don't like putting power manipulation into this macro. I like it. Use it if you want to. You can always take it out if you don't want that hitting with Shifting Blades. But I really enjoy it, so I put it in there. Alright. So our second burst macro here is another Shifting Blades macro, basically, but it's paired around Alacrity and Combat Focus. Now this is the big, big burst that Paragon is going to have. This is what's going to basically flatline anybody that's at 50% health. If you hit them with this big burst macro and you've got a decent weapon that does decent DPS, you might as well just forget about it if you crit, because they're going to be flatlined and hitting the ground face first. Alright, so then after that we have our charge macro, which I put Thunderous Leap in there. If you do not have that planar ability, then do not put it in there. I put it in first because if I'm out of combat, I would like to go ahead and use Thunderous Leap first. And I have it set for a GTAE, so it's going to Thunderous Leap on top of the target rather than having to target the ground where you want to land. But the main time it's going to be using Thread the Trees, which is our main charge and also a damage increase, so make sure that you have that going. Alright, on our bar down here we have the main build macro, we have the finisher macro, we have the first burst, the second burst, we have Flurry, which is a ranged channeled attack, which is pretty good if you're getting kited around. It's really good to use that. We got our charge macro, we have Fleet of Foot, which is going to increase our movement speed by 50% for 21 seconds. And then we have Elude, which I was just talking about that earlier. It's a leap back and it also removes all crowd control effects. So if you are being locked down, make sure to use that even if you don't need to leap back. If your break free is down, it's going to save your butt against all those pyros, put it that way. Alright, then we have Break Free on a separate button. Do not put it in your macros, guys. A lot of people put it in the macros and they're screwing everything up whenever they do that, because take, for instance, if somebody snares you and they're at full health, you know, if you have it in your build macro, then you're going to use that break free. And then all of a sudden they stun you after that, and then they proceed to kill you, or a bunch of people start running up and you can't get out of it all of a sudden because you used your break free on something that you shouldn't have. Never put in your macros, guys. Always have break free on a separate button. All right, then we have flinching strike, which is our interrupt. And the bad part about that is it's a melee range interrupt, so you're not going to be able to interrupt people from a range, but it's good that we have one. I've been noticing a lot of people putting their interrupts in their macros. Don't do that, guys. For the same reasons we don't put our break free in there, because take, for instance, you go up to a pyro and he starts casting a fireball or something. You know, all of a sudden your flinching strike goes off on that fireball, and then he turns around and does a fusillade on you. And that's what you really wanted to interrupt. Or he does one of his mastery heals that's a channeled ability. That's what you want to interrupt. You don't want to use it on stuff that is minor, and you're going to do that if you put it in your macros. All right, then we have wrist strike, which is debilitate for 5 seconds. And then we have predictable movements, which is a stun for 4 seconds, which is really, really nice, because if you debilitate somebody and they stay in the fight while they're taking a lot of damage from you, and then all of a sudden, shortly after, you hit that stun and you blow them up, they're really going to regret they stood in the fight with you. All right, so that's our main stuff there. I will go ahead and show you how to play this build now. And it's really simple. It's just a matter of keeping up with your shifting blades and your alacrity. That's the two main things. Basically, whenever you go up and you target somebody, let's say you charge in because you want to go ahead and use your charges, you start using your build macro. Okay, as soon as you get some damage going, you're most likely going to have readiness up at all times during a warfront or a CQ or whatever. As you can see, I have my K alerts to show it at the bottom under my character's feet there. If you can see it, it shows that I have 5 stacks of readiness, which is going to increase my attack power by a lot. And I want that up as much as possible. And it's going to naturally be up to 5 stacks as long as you're hitting people. So once you have that up, you know, you don't have to have it up, but it's just a damage increase. Once you have that up, you may want to go ahead and hit your first burst macro. Alright, so it's going to use our shifting blades and use up all 3 combo points. And as you can see, it did a lot of damage right there. I kept hitting it until I got 3 combo points again. Because that first shifting blades is going to use up your 3 combo points. Always have all 3 combo points up whenever you first start that burst macro. It's going to use all 3 combo points, and then you keep hitting it until you're back up to 3 combo points. That's going to let you know that your burst macro is done. Alright, so after that, you're probably going to start hitting your builder macro and finish your macro over and over. You know, it's just waiting until shifting blades comes back up, because that's going to be your burst. Your reaping harvest finisher is going to hit for a ton of damage, so you're going to be really wrecking people even without your burst macro. Alright, so now we're back up to 5 stacks of readiness. I'm going to go ahead and hit my really big burst macro, which is the alacrity one, and it's also going to cast combat focus in it. Alright, so we hit it, uses up our combo points, and sets it up. Boom, look at that huge column of tons of damage you see there. And then we go right back into our builder macro and finisher. Now, the thing that you need to really keep in mind is that second burst macro, you have to have shifting blades up as well, because it relies on that. So that's why I have it to where my first burst macro shows shifting blades, my second one shows alacrity. So whenever I look down at my action bars down there and I see that shifting blades is up and alacrity is up, I know I can use my big burst. All right, so after that, say somebody is kiting you around and you're having trouble getting to them, you can go ahead and hit your flurry, which is going to be a ranged channel attack, and you can move while you're using it. So I'm going to go ahead and hit it. As you can see, my character's doing the old whirlwind swords attack there, but that's our flurry. That's going to hit for a decent amount of damage. I really don't use it that often unless I get kited, but you know, just the other abilities, I can usually stick on people pretty good. So, but if you start seeing that they're casting something, make sure that you hit your flinching strike. Try to keep in mind that you want to use your debilitate and your stun whenever needed. You don't want to sit there and have them on off a cooldown all the time and never use them. Usually if I'm fighting somebody, I'll use one, but I'll keep the other one ready just in case the situation calls for it. Say, for instance, I'm fighting one person, I'm getting them really low. All of a sudden, their buddy comes up. Well, I want to kill that first person before I fight that second person. So I'll go ahead and switch targets and use my stun or something and then go ahead and kill that first person to where I can go ahead and fight the second person now. But if I had used both of my control abilities on that first person, I would be dead meat whenever the second person came up. So that's basically this build. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure that you hit that like button. If you want to be supportive of the channel, we got a donation button down there. If you are absolutely awesome, you can hit that donation button. Or else, all of my characters are listed in the description below as well. If you'd like to send something in the mail in-game to me, such as a Rex or something to support the channel, I highly appreciate everything you guys do. You are the most amazing people I know, and I absolutely love you. So, if you're new to Rift, make sure that you use my referral link in the description below. You get a cape, you get an extra bag, you get some cool auras to put on your weapons, all kinds of cool stuff, and it'll really help you out if you're a new player to Rift. So make sure you use that referral link if you are just starting your account. So as usual, guys, my name is Grim, and I will see you next time.